Hallelujah be the loudest. It's testimony time. Can someone say my breakthrough time? Let's listen to the following documented testimonies. Praise God. Thank God for last semester's result. Last semester was really hectic for me. I had a very shaky mid-semester result. And during the exams, I had two specific papers for which I had settled for Fs. But I kept praying and asking God for a 5-point result. Although the devil kept discouraging me, however, I held on to my faith. To the glory of God and to the shame of the devil, I emerged with an outstanding result to the glory of God. Show me, Mofin, follower. Put your hands together for Jesus. Secondly, I'm thanking God for my result last semester. I'd believed God for a particular result, but to no avail. During the summer break, God told me I did not take him seriously enough, so I decided to do so and tie my stewardship to my academics. I'm thanking God for his faithfulness during my last semester results, which was the best I've ever had. Turn to your neighbor, tell the person, take God seriously, and your results will be outstanding. This is from Ajogbe Dominic. The third one says, praise God, I'm thanking God for the resurrection power of Jesus in my life for over a year now. For a while, it had been difficult to read my notes and to concentrate. But I thank God that since the exam started, it had been easy for me to read and understand and remember all I've read and I've been taught. For the first time in a long time, I've been prepared. I've actually been fully prepared for every examination. Someone that knows that God will help you to prepare for remaining papers, shout hallelujah. This is from Fajemisin Zina. Next, I'm thanking God for a wonderful alpha semester result. At the beginning of the semester, things were really tough because my program was really demanding. I really wanted a good result, and I decided to do things differently. I came for chapel scrubbing and took spirituality seriously. I then told God that if he would give me a 5-point result or a first class, I would testify to his name. As a result of all this, when my result came out, all my papers were awesome, back to back, from TMC to GEC to CHE, to God alone be all the glory. This is Omolewa Daniel. All your results will be awesome this semester in the name of Jesus. I want to thank God for his faithfulness in my life. Last semester, GEC 117 was a challenging one for me. I cried many times because I was literally scared of carrying over the course. During the exam period, I claimed the prophecies and came to pray on the altar, asking God to help me in the course. I want to thank God because I passed the course and every other course. Every course that you're fearful about will be turned to a testimony for you in the name of Jesus. This is from Onoja Favor. And finally, I'm thanking God for my life, for the life of my family and loved ones. Since March, my mom had been preparing for a promotional examination, and I'm thanking God that she passed the first and second screening stages, from which she came out second. Thank God for moving her from a level of glory to another. She has been moved from divisional head to assistant director. Someone say, thank you, Jesus. Also, I'm thanking God for the completion of my sister's master's program in Nottingham, Trent. I'm thanking God for all the piled up job opportunities for her. Lastly, I'm thanking God, the keeper of creation and the creator of all, the architect of my first class result this semester, the one who was bruised and brought healing and has healed me and my family, and the one who was pierced and has erased pains from my life. To him alone be all the glory. This is from Akindele Christiana. Someone that will enjoy God this examination, lift up your hands and say, thank you, Jesus. Let's welcome the choir.
Hallelujah. To the person right now who's wondering, how am I going to succeed these exams? How am I going to come through papers and the difficult courses with a bad CA and a poor record? I want you to know that God is making a way for you. God is making a way for you where there seems to be no way. For his word says, I will do a new thing. I will make rivers in the desert. I will make a way in the wilderness for you. Hallelujah. Made a way. I don't know how, but you did it. But holding on to faith you know best. 'Cause nothing can catch you by surprise. You've got this figured out, and you're watching us now. And when it looks as if we can't win, you wrap us in your arms and step in. That's the kind of God he is. And everything we need you supply. You've got this in control. And now I know that you made a way. When my back was against the wall and it looked as if it was over, you made a way. Yes, and I'm standing here only because you made a way. I don't know what you're going through right now, but my God will make a way. Yeah. And now we're here, looking back at where we've come from. Oh, yeah. Because of you and nothing we've done to deserve the love and mercy you've shown. Your grace was strong enough to pick me up, and you made a way when our backs were and then look at. Yeah, but you're standing here only because you made. had nowhere else to go. That the devil was putting ideas in my head. That this was the end. But it's not over, no. God, I still gotta do it for you.
Round of applause. Praise the Lord. Lift up your voice to heaven and give him praise. Magnify his name. Glorify his majesty. Lift up your voice to heaven. Give him the glory that is due to him. If you can think you can give him thanks, you are here before the presence of the Most High God. Alive and well, all your organs working. Lift up your voice to heaven. Appreciate him for the breath of God that is in your nostrils. Give him the glory that is due to him. Honor him this hour. You can do better than that. You can appreciate him in the spirit. Le kapa le brozondo le mashanga ba le boriala katara zala brakata blakatara bashanda la basheke tekere la bazan. Father, we thank you. Father, we give you glory and praise. We thank you for your faithfulness in this camp. We thank you for what you are doing in the lives of these your precious sons and daughters. Sweet Holy Spirit, we can feel your presence again. We put our hands again into your hands. We ask that you lead us on, open our understanding as the word of God is coming our way. As we look into the perfect law of liberty this morning, let every form of captivity be turned into liberty in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let's give Jesus a powerful clap offering this morning as you take your seat. Shout a big hallelujah. Understanding the power of thanksgiving, part three. Understanding the power of thanksgiving, that's our series for this month. Part three. The importance of thanksgiving in the lives of believers cannot be overemphasized. Thanksgiving among others is a spiritual platform for securing fulfillment of prophecies. That's why we are commanded in scriptures in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18. It says, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. If you look at that verse of scripture, it didn't say concerning us. Very instructive. Concerning you. Yes, you. You put your name there. You, concerning you. In everything, irrespective of what is happening around your destiny per time, you owe him thanks. You owe him thanks. Because that's the will of God. And that is the only time that the promises of God will find expression in your life. In Hebrews chapter 10, verse 36, the Bible says, for ye have need of patience, that after ye have done the will of God, which is thanksgiving, said ye might receive the promise. So without thanksgiving, you can never receive any blessing from heaven. Thanksgiving will always move God to perform wonders in the lives of those who engage in the practice. We shared a testimony here, I think last week, about the lady that gave thanks 7,000 times, and then God turned around her captivity for the better. You know why we share such testimonies? You know, testimonies are spiritual arrows. They will always hit at the target. They have inbuilt capacity to replicate results. Testimonies. And I think on Sunday, one of the students here shared a testimony. Hedged in somehow and then decided to give God thanks. I think she said 100 times. And everything turned. Jesus had just the privilege of receiving 5 loaves of barley bread and then 2 small fishes from somebody, a little boy's lunch pack, and then decided to appreciate God for that provision, and it multiplied. Any ungrateful person never succeeds. Put the person inside the White House. They'll be moving from one room to another. It's just a matter of time, and then they will identify the heart and then flush the person out of that environment. And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed to the disciples, and the disciples to them that were set down, and likewise of the fishes, as much as they would. It refused to finish. No matter what you have in your hands, as far as you are a genuine thanksgiver, that thing will multiply. When we give God thanks for what he has done, we remind him of what remains. We remind him of what remains. He's the God of principles. We remind him of what remains when we give him thanks. Nothing moves God like thanksgiving. For those of us here, the students here writing exams, you see, I feel grateful to God. In fact, I remain ever grateful to God each time you conclude your something, and I see some of you dancing and rejoicing and appreciating God. It shows that you know what you're doing. And some will just move like heathens and then back to the hall and go and lie down and be waiting for the next time to write exam. You are undoing yourself. And if you look around now, you discover that a lot of people are not here. Majority of them are not here. What are they going to tell us? Is it not Thanksgiving? Oh, hallelujah. We're waiting for the time. You know, if you come here, we'll just waste 2 hours and then. He is the owner of the time. He created the time. He lives outside of time. And gave you just a particular season to operate here on earth. Simple wisdom demands that you connect heaven in anything you do here. In this limited time you have. When you disregard God in your life, you will discover that the little time you think you have will never make any meaning to you. And most times, if you don't value God, he will ensure, if God is a God of principles. He will ensure that the time that you are claiming that you are, having for yourself, maybe for your revision, will never make any mark. Most times they fall off and then and start sleeping and start snoring. And then wake up at the time that we conclude the service, which means they miss both ways. You didn't get anything there, and you didn't get anything here. Wisdom is profitable to direct. Only the truly thankful can be truly praiseful. Because when you are genuinely thankful, you are joyful. And we must remember that joy is an essential requirement for the praise that works. That's why he said, is any among you afflicted, let him pray. Is any merry, let him sing psalms. So if you are not merry, you are not qualified to sing psalms. If you are not merry and you sing psalms, the psalms may not be acceptable to him. But the state of your heart is a factor. That's why we must guard against every form of complaints and murmuring. Murmuring is a disease, incurable disease. Is a proof of ingratitude, which breaks the joy of his victim and ultimately destroys the individual. That's why it says in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 10, he said, neither murmur ye, as some of them also murmured and were destroyed of the destroyer. You shall not be destroyed. That amen is somehow. I said, you shall not be destroyed. We have examples from pages of scriptures where the people murmured, and then have that account in Numbers chapter 11, 1 to 3. They murmured, and the Lord heard them and became angry, and then sent fire into the camp, and the fire consumed the ringleaders and every one of them that were part of the murmuring. So thanksgiving, we are reminded again that thanksgiving should be our lifestyle. Should be our lifestyle. If we must see the program of God for your life come to pass, if you must see the finger of God come to pass, particularly in some things that you find yourself engaging in, here on earth, thanksgiving, very important, thanksgiving, thanksgiving. What is thanksgiving? What is thanksgiving? We're looking at thanksgiving again from another perspective. What is thanksgiving? Thanksgiving is appreciation of the present in anticipation of the future. Appreciation of the present in anticipation of the future. Just like that account in John chapter 6, 6 to 11, Jesus gave thanks for the provision of the 5 barley loaves and 2 fishes in anticipation of their multiplication. He knew what he would do. That's why he said, make them sit down. And they sat down. Where is the bread? They brought it something. What about the fishes? They brought it something. And now lifted it up and then gave thanks and blessed the bread. And then gave it to the disciples, and the disciples now were ordered to distribute. Appreciation of the present in anticipation of the future. Some of our students here, after the one paper or something, some will come out and then feel very happy. Some will feel very just be moody and just be moving up and down and just be complaining and reacting. That's not the way. Father, I thank you. Father, I thank you. I thank you. Some have even gone to a point of even calling themselves names. Ha! This brain, where have you been? Where were you when I entered the hall? He said I was there. It's just I refused to give thanks. You are not through with the exams. You apply some of these principles. No challenge whatsoever. You are not confused once. No challenge with your head. You have enough reasons to appreciate him. Now, why must we give thanks? Why must we give thanks? Thanksgiving is the platform for supernatural multiplication. It is the platform for supernatural multiplication. Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 19, the Bible says, and out of them shall proceed thanksgiving. Out of them shall proceed thanksgiving. And the voice of them that make merry, and I will multiply them. And I will multiply them. And they shall not be few. I will also glorify them, and they shall not be small. I will multiply them. Out of them shall proceed thanksgiving. And then he will multiply the graces of heaven upon your life. He will multiply his wisdom at work in your life. He will ensure that your mentality remains ever boosted. He will ensure that inspiration from heaven flows towards your direction unhindered. Out of them shall proceed thanksgiving. I see that becoming your lot and portion in the name of Jesus. Why must we give him thanks? If not for anything, that breath that is in your nostrils has a source. It's not yours, as it were. It has its root in God. Psalm 150 verse 6, he said, let everything that had breath do what? Praise the Lord. Give him thanks. Praise him. Appreciate him. Be grateful to him. Now the question is this. What are we thanking God for? What are we thanking God for? Number one, for his wondrous works in our lives, particularly as we continue to count your blessings. That's why we sing that song, count your blessings, name them one by one. And it will surprise you to see what the Lord has done. Count your blessings. Count your blessings. Count your blessings. Some people are incapacitated to a point that they don't move. They can't move from one place to another. They are carried. They carry them. I know somebody in my place. I believe it's just the heart that sentenced him to that kind of something. He has a special chair, white chair, plastic chair. He sits on the something. And then if you drop him here, he will be there. No movement. Until he gets the people. He pays people that carry him from one place to another. He has a vehicle. He has a car. That chair is inside the car. Those people, he pays. They are his staff. Personal staff. Employed to carry him. He attends functions, and then when he arrives, they will now put him in a plastic chair. He will wear the red cap or something. They will now carry him and dump him there. He will just be greeting everybody. When the event is over, they will now carry him again. But you came in here. If they asked you to run, and you took off. And you still don't see any reason why you need to return the glory that is due to him. How much are you paying him for the oxygen that you are taking free of charge? Your organs working perfectly. Some people cannot sit down the way we are sitting down. because of pains. They can't sit down that way. The only way, if you want to see them out, you have to bring something like bed for them to lie down. So in the night, they are lying down. In the daytime, they are lying down. If you can think, you can give him thanks. That's what the psalmist says. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. All that is within me, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. You want to see thunder? Forget. Forget not all his benefits. He said, who forgiveth all thy iniquities? Who healeth all thy diseases? Some people are mobile pharmacy. They carry drugs, all manner of drugs in their bags. They will be in a meeting, highly placed in the society, in a meeting, and then at a particular point, they will just excuse me. They will not open the briefcase and bring out there. That is what is sustaining their heart. It's not every food that is served that they take. They will bring something, they say, excuse me, I don't take that. I don't worry, I don't feel like it. Not that he doesn't want to eat, but he can't take it. Because if he takes it, the entire system will scatter. Are you not grateful to God that you eat anything? They bring akpu, you finish, wham, eba, oh, hallelujah. Anything, fried rice, oh, chicken a la carte, Czechoslovak ovichnadum, egg buja, all manner of food you eat. And they don't trouble you. And you go to toilet freely. Hey, some people use machine to go to toilet. Are you not aware? Some people have not been able to use tissue paper by reason of the state of their health. They do evacuation of their colon. They do evacuate something. I don't know how they just use something. But here we are. Just move in, enter the toilet, and then you bomb the whole place, and then you come out, and then appreciate God, and then you are on your way and say, oh, hallelujah, amen, amen. And you think you don't have any reason to give him praise. Now listen to me. I have been in an environment where we were praying for a student to poo-poo for over 7 days. All the drugs that they applied didn't do anything. All the drugs, no effect. To a point that we are praying and then sprinkling the blood and then anointing with oil for the young man to go to the toilet. Transferred to Lutz for your information. I don't know what they did there. Then they now applied from anywhere and then they were able to pull out some things before the guy got there himself. Did you use the toilet this morning? Lift up your right hand and say, thank you, Jesus. Very simple. Number two, for things that we are persuaded of in the world. We study the world, we discover some things, some blessings, promises that belongs to you and I, and we are persuaded that we make it good in our lives, we give him thanks for that. Romans chapter 4, 20 and 21, the Bible says, he staggered not, talking about Father Abraham, he staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strong in faith, giving glory to God, and being fully persuaded that what he had promised, he was able also to perform. You give him thanks to ensure that what is written finds expression in your life and destiny. In 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 12, the Bible says, "For the which cause I also suffer these things," Apostle Paul speaking, he said, "nevertheless, I am not ashamed. I am not ashamed. For I know whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I have committed unto him against that day." So based on the promises of God from the basis of scriptures, you appreciate him in advance. For example, you shall be the head and not the tail. And you are writing an example. So wisdom demands that you give him praise. Appreciate him. Because that prophetic word will find expression in your life in the name of Jesus. Can I hear a big amen? Amen. Number three, for things we anticipate, such as supernatural restoration. Supernatural restoration. Something that can only be done by him, not by man. And you know that he will do it. You give him thanks. John chapter 11. The gospel according to St. John chapter 11. Talking about Jesus Christ at the tomb of Lazarus. John chapter 11. From verse 40. Jesus said unto her, "Said I not unto thee, that if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God?" Verse 41. Then they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid, and Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, "Father, I thank thee that thou hast heard me. And I knew that thou hearest me always. But because of the people which stand by, I said it, that they may believe that thou hast sent me." And when he has thus had spoken, he cried with a loud voice, "Lazarus, come forth." Verse 44. And he that was dead came forth, bound hand and foot with grave cloths, and his face was bound about with a napkin. Jesus said unto him, "Loose him and let him go." Whatever that has chained your success will receive fire from heaven right now. Whatever that is working against your academic progress here receives the fire of God from heaven right now. Can I hear a big amen? That amen is still slow. If you still have breath in your nostrils, can I hear a breakthrough? Amen. Yeah. Number four. With thanksgiving, we keep scaling higher heights. Higher heights. You remember the part of just like a shining light that shineth more and more, even unto a perfect day. Habakkuk chapter 3, verses 18 and 19. He said, "Yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. The Lord God is my strength, and he will make my feet like hinds' feet, and he will make me to walk upon my high places." Thanksgiving is the mystery behind scaling unusual heights. Unusual heights. Thanksgiving. Ever thankful is ever fruitful and ever progressive. Nothing is ever late with thanksgiving. Nothing is ever late with thanksgiving. That is why wisdom demands that we consider what I have captioned, perils of ingratitude. Perils of ingratitude. Listen to me. It is risky and perilous to be ungrateful to God for all his blessings we enjoy on a daily basis. Very risky. Very risky. Very risky. Remember, he daily loaded us with his benefits according to Psalm 68, verse 19. Perish from the pages of scriptures. Very frightening. If we understand these things, then we discover that we'll have a reason to give him thanks. We'll have a reason to remain ever grateful to him. Now, Jeremiah chapter 13. Jeremiah, the book of Jeremiah chapter 13. Jeremiah chapter 13, from verse 15. He said, hear ye and give ear. Be not proud, for the Lord has spoken. Look at verse 16. He said, give glory to the Lord your God before he caused darkness. Did you see that? Before he caused darkness and before your feet stumble upon the dark mountains and while you look for light, he turned it into the shadow of death and make it gross darkness. God, very dangerous. Darkness, as it were, swallows up the person's destiny. And anytime you see darkness in scriptures, you are talking about every manifestation of evil. Satanic manifestation, all demonic impute and everything, they will not take over. Which can be cheaply handled by light. You will just step aside and darkness takes over. It shall never be our portion in the name of Jesus. But if ye will not hear it, my soul shall weep in secret places for your pride. Say, God forbid. And my eyes shall weep sore and run down with tears because the Lord's flock is carried away captive. In other words, the person enters into deeper captivity. Deeper captivity. With the enemy having the upper hand. That's number one. Darkness overruns the person's destiny. And then the person will just be groping in the dark. And then no direction, nothing, and then everything is just haywire. It shall never be our portion in the name of Jesus. Number two, the blessings are turned to curses. The blessings, the ones that you have received that you have refused to appreciate him about, and then see, they are turned to curses. Malachi chapter 2, 1, it said, and now, O ye priests, this commandment is for you. If you will not hear, and if you will not lay it to heart to give glory unto my name, said the Lord of hosts, he said, I will even send a curse upon you. I will curse your blessings. Yea, I have cursed them already, because you do not lay it to heart. Look at verse 3. He said, behold, I will corrupt your seed. Say, God forbid. And spread dung upon your faces. You know the meaning of dung? The poo-poo of cows and cattle and all those things. Say, we'll carry it and use it as perfume. Pia. Or the powder that women put on their faces. They just put it in containers and then using dung and be doing the makeup. That's the Bible for you. Say, spread dungs upon your faces. Even the dung of your solemn feast, and one shall take you away with it. Say, God forbid. I refuse to be ungrateful. God forbid. You say, our seed becomes corrupted. Corruption all over the way. And number three, you discover that you can't fight any battle. Irrespective of the weapons of warfare at your disposal, you can't operate those weapons. We have our weapons here in this ministry. You are not grateful. You apply anointing oil, your anointing is not working. Check yourself. Check your obedience level. You do feet washing, it's not working for you. Something is wrong. You take communion 5 times a day. The thing that is crying is still crying. Something is definitely wrong. What is it that is wrong? Let's trace from scriptures. The psalmist says in Psalm 78 from verse 9. 78 from 9. He said, the children of Ephraim being armed and carried in the day of battle. You are armed in their disposition with AK-47 assault rifle, all manner of weapons. They were armed. And the day of battle, they couldn't use the weapons. They turned back. Why? Verse 10. They kept not the covenant of God and refused to walk in his ways. Like what? Verse 11. And forgot his works and his wonders that he has showed them. They forgot. Well, it's normally, okay, we are covenant children. Oh, that's what we are supposed to be. He's our God. He's the one there. He's the one doing it. Let him continue. If he likes to do it, let him continue to do it. If he doesn't want to do it, hallelujah. Are you aware that he's expecting appreciation from you? He's expecting us to return to tell him, Father, I thank you. Number 4. The destruction becomes the lot and portion of such people. The building process from heaven comes to an end. How do we know? The psalmist says in Psalm 28. Psalm 28. Very popular scripture. Psalm 28, verse 5. Because they regard not the works of the Lord, nor the operations of his hands, he shall destroy them and not build them up. Can I hear a bigger God forbid? Is somebody grateful at all to God? And you are still alive and well. And you are awake. Some people are already sleeping. And you are awake. Can you join me as you rise up? Lift up your two and say, Father, I thank you. Begin to appreciate him. Begin to appreciate him. Begin to give him the glory that is due to him. There must be a reason why you must return this morning to give him glory. If you can think you can give him praise, appreciate him. Appreciate him. Appreciate him. Appreciate him. Eternal Rock of Ages, we thank you. We give you glory and praise. What a joy. What a privilege of standing strong, alive and well in the sanctuary this morning, in the land of the living. Is somebody appreciating God at all? For those of you that are writing exams, lift up your voice and give him praise. Appreciate him for the wisdom of God that is finding expression since the beginning of this examination. Lift up your voice and give him praise. Lift up your voice and appreciate him. Glorify his majesty. If you can think, you can give him praise. Malera zuri alama shaga balebro kotoliama katanza ndengambanga. Everlasting Father, we thank you. Everlasting Father, we give you praise. Malero zika papra tuliama shara zindalia kapataza. Father, we thank you. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Can I hear a big amen? Amen? Now, one thing is needful. What is that? In case you are here and you know that something is wrong with your relationship with your Heavenly Father, that blood of Jesus that was shed on the cross of Calvary must never be in vain. Can I hear a big amen? Amen? In case you are here, the safest place to be, particularly now in this dispensation, this end time, is in Christ. All heads bowed. In case you are here in this service, you need to make amends. Jesus Christ in our midst. Say, behold, I stand on the door of your heart and I knock. If you open, I will come in. If you don't open, well, but he has assured us that he's going to come in. He's going to sup with you. He's going to fellowship with you. He's going to grant you a brand new opportunity to live a meaningful life. Lift up your voice in case you are part of such people. Place your right hand on your chest and invite Jesus. He's here in our midst. that you don't see him does not negate the fact that he's here. Place your right hand on your chest and then call upon him. Say, Jesus, come into my heart. In case you missed it in time past, he said, return, I will return unto you. Call upon him too. He will grant you a perfect beginning, brand new beginning, to the point that you become a surprise to yourself. Talk to him. He's here. He's here. Say, come unto me, all ye that are heavy laden. He said, I'm going to give you rest. I'm going to give you rest. If your life is presently experiencing some challenges, storms of life, check your relationship with him. You can return. You can return. When you return, he's going to return unto you. When he enters that boat, there's always calm and quietness. Invite Jesus into your heart. It's a spiritual issue. It's between you and your heavenly Father. When you do that, what happens is that your spirit man that has been dead will jack back to life. So for you are dead in your trespasses, call upon him. Jesus, come into my heart. Give me a brand new beginning. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Father, thank you. I know that you are not a man that will lie. Your yes is your yes and your no is your no. You have given me the understanding that if I return, you're going to return. Thank you for saving me, Jesus. Thank you for saving me, Jesus. Thank you for giving me the second opportunity, the second chance. Jesus, I thank you. Father, we give you glory and praise. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Can I hear a big amen?